Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadro, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Well, everyone loves to go on vacation, but no one would leave their house without a map telling them how to get to their destination. And everyone can log in to Facebook, LinkedIn, or Twitter and post an update. To be truly great at social media, you need a roadmap. Not only do you need a roadmap, but you need to understand how to read it and interpret it. In today's edition of the TRICOM Industry Insider webinar, The Roadmap, a Step-by-Step Guide to Social Media Success, Brad Bailey, Social Media Marketing Consultant with Haley Marketing Group, will walk through the roadmap that has assisted over 65 staffing firms and contributed to 6 ASA award-winning social media marketing campaigns. In this session, you'll have time to ask specific questions related to your company and learn how to define SMART goals, how to conceptualize a strategy, how to outline tactics, where to focus your time and energy, how to develop a posting calendar that saves you time. By the end of this session, you'll know the step-by-step guide to achieving social media success. Our presenter today, Brad, is a social media and content marketing strategist at Haley Marketing Group, the nation's largest marketing firm dedicated to servicing the staffing and recruiting industry. Brad has over 4 years of experience in the staffing and recruiting industry, helping organizations develop and implement strategic digital marketing plans to reach defined business goals. As a digital marketing expert, Brad has advised over 65 staffing and recruiting firms on social media marketing, blogging, content marketing, email marketing, and search engine optimization. He has guided the strategy and delivered multiple industry award-winning social media campaigns. Brad oversees and implements the comprehensive social media marketing campaign for Haley Marketing Group and manages the product development of Haley Marketing Group's Social Pro service, an award-winning social media marketing solution designed specifically for the staffing industry. He is a consistent contributor to Lunch with Haley, Haley Marketing's educational webinar series for the staffing industry, and has presented his past industry-specific conferences. Websites, social media, SEO, blogging, email marketing, PPC, for more than 20 years, Haley Marketing has served the staffing industry. Their work has won more than 65 Genius and Voice Awards from ASA, and they can help you stand out and stay on top of mind and sell more. If you have any questions during the presentation, please utilize the Q&A feature or the chat feature located on the right toolbar. After the presentation, there will be time for questions and an opportunity for you to give us your feedback on today's webinar by completing a short exit poll. With that, I will turn the floor over to Brad.
Thank you very much for the introduction, Amanda. It's great to be with everybody this afternoon. I'm really looking forward to sharing what I consider the roadmap to social media success. Just going to click over to the slides, and we will get underway here. Everybody loves to go on vacation, but when you set out for a destination that looks like this, and you end up somewhere like this, you realize very quickly that you have yourself a problem. So what can you do to prevent that negative outcome from happening? Well, if you know you're going on a vacation, you can sit down with your friend or family member, whoever you're taking on that trip. You can plot out your end destination and draw a line back to where you're starting from. You can physically chart on the roadmap how to be successful in your trip. Or if you're like me, you wake up the morning of, You pull open Waze or Google Maps or Apple Maps, and you let your phone guide you on the path to success. You let your phone tell you exactly how to get from point A to point B, turn by turn. Your social media marketing strategy should be exactly the same. If we don't know our end destination and we don't know the goal of the overall campaign, we'll never know if the strategies and tactics that we're deploying are successful. Without knowing the end destination, we'll never know if what we're doing is leading us on the path to success. So where do we get started? When we think about the roadmap to social media success and new social platforms popping up by the month, social platforms changing by the day, where should we really get started? We begin with step one, which is defining your goals. Before we even think about social media, we need to understand what your goals as a staffing firm are, and then how we can leverage social media tactics to ultimately reach those goals. Without defining our goals, but without identifying the end destination, we'll never know if the tactics we deploy are successful. And when I say define your goals, I mean define SMART goals. A SMART goal is specific, it's measurable, it's achievable, it's realistic, and it's time-bound. Without identifying a SMART goal, we really just have a hope or a wish. If we say in the month of February, I want to generate more applications, that's a hope. If we say I want to generate more welding applications, now we have a specific goal. If we say I'd really like to generate 50 more welding applications, we have a measurable goal. We'll assume that that's achievable. We'll assume that 50 more welding applications in the month of February is something that your team and the tactics that you're deploying can generate. We'll also assume that 50 is a realistic number, in that maybe you're in healthcare staffing and you've never done welding or you've never found welders for assignments. So that wouldn't be a realistic goal to try to generate 50 in the month. But if you're constantly generating 20 to 30, it's probably realistic. And then we'll put a time-bound stamp on it. I want to generate 50 new welding applications by February 20th. Now we have a SMART goal. We've taken our wish and our hope, and we've converted it to something that is quantifiable, is measurable, and is extremely specific. On the roadmap to social media success, we'll constantly come back to step one. As we look at defining our goals and we start to deploy strategies and tactics, it's critical that we always come back to step one, start with our foundation, and make sure that our goal is still a primary focus and a primary concern. We always want to keep sight on what we're ultimately trying to achieve so that we can be certain that the strategies and tactics that we're deploying are in line with our overall business goal. Which leads us to step two on the roadmap, conceptualizing your strategy. In the slides ahead, I'm going to go through very specific strategies for social media to reach these two main goals of every staffing firm. So I'm gonna kind of deviate away from this step for right now because I am gonna go into length into this concept later on. But I want to address that step two in the roadmap is to conceptualize your strategy. From there, we have our third and final step in the roadmap to social media success, outlining your tactics. The tactics, for me, are really the fun part of social media. Using Facebook jobs, sharing content on LinkedIn, posting in LinkedIn groups. Maybe it's looking at Google Plus communities or sharing on Twitter. Those are all very tactical decisions that we make on a day-to-day basis. What we do in that stage of the process can pivot. It can change day by day. But ultimately, we want to make sure that the tactics that we're deploying are in line with our main goal, generating applications. Maybe it's generating more job orders. But ultimately, we want to make sure that the tactics that we are deploying day after day are in line with our overall business goal. So again, this is the roadmap. It's a step-by-step guide to social media success. As Amanda mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, if you have any questions, please feel free to use the chat window, the question window. I'd love to address them either during the presentation, if it's timely and on one of the topics that we're discussing. If not, we can save them till the end, and I'd be more than available and happy to answer those questions for you. As I'm going through tactics and strategies, if you've tried any of them, I'd love to know your feedback in the chat window, in the question and answer window, whichever you're more comfortable with. But please feel free to put your feedback in there. And let's make this a little bit of a conversation so that we can have a back and forth dialogue about the tactics, the strategies that I'm going to outline in the slides ahead. Jay Baer is the founder of Convince and Convert. He has a quote that I use in every single presentation that I give where he says, the goal is not to be good at social media. The goal is to be good at business because of social media. This is critical. When you look at staffing firms across the country, and even if you look at different organizations running social media campaigns across the country, the primary focus for an overwhelming majority of them is to be good at social media. They want to understand the tools, and they want to be able to do all of the new and exciting trends on social media. That is not the main goal. That's not why we're here. The goal is to be good at business because of the tool that is social media. Using social media as a tactic, we are going to be good at business. We are going to improve our business because of social media. And while I say that, it's important that you understand how to use the tools. Having a good understanding of your goals and understanding of the strategy won't necessarily mean that you know how to use the wrench and go in there and know how to use Facebook. So having a good elementary foundation of Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Google+, Snapchat, Instagram, any of these social platforms, understanding the tool doesn't necessarily make you a great plumber. So you need to understand how to use the tools and then ultimately come back to this foundation for ultimate success. Again, in the words of Jay Baer, the goal is not to be good at social media. The goal is to be good at business because of the tool that is social media. So what are the two goals of every staffing agency? Well, as I talk to different owner or staffing specialist or recruiter, I keep coming back to the two main goals. First is to generate more job applications. The second is to generate more job orders. Orders in and applicants that can fill those orders. Those are the two main goals of every staffing firm. If we look at these as goals as the foundation, we can then move forward and conceptualize our strategy. How can we use social media to ultimately reach these goals? So let's look at what drives job applications. Job board visits, form submissions, telephone calls directly to your office. Maybe it's an email to one of your recruiters or a staffing specialist on your team. Website visits, becoming an employer of choice or establishing a referral program. Maybe it's attracting new candidates or activating passive candidates, reactivating past candidates, or showcasing your brand identity. All of these strategies would ultimately lead us towards a goal of securing more job applications. When we look at job orders, contact form submissions, again, telephone calls to the office. Maybe it's a one-on-one contact with one of your team members. Maybe it's a website visit or becoming a trusted resource. Establishing credibility, becoming a thought leader in your local market. Becoming a thought leader is tough to quantify, but I believe I've identified tactics that can ultimately get us to that strategy and then push us towards our goal of driving more job orders. We can also reactivate past clients through skill marketing. We can activate new clients, and we can use social to create brand awareness, which will ultimately drive more job orders as people come to you instead of your competition. the tactics. This is the part of the presentation where I really welcome your conversation in the chat window and in the Q&A window. I have them both open. But as I go through the tactics that will fuel the strategies that I've outlined on the slides before, if you've tried any, if you've implemented some of these, if you have questions about any of them, let's get that dialogue going in that chat window so that we can continue this conversation and expand on it. If you have a question, the chances are high that somebody else has the same question. One important note, we've identified our goals. We've conceptualized the strategies that would ultimately help us reach those goals, even surpass those goals. When we look at tactics, it's important to start with one of these. When you're comfortable, begin to implement another and continuously grow your social media campaign. I've outlined what I've counted at 25 different tactics that you can leverage on social media on a day-to-day basis that will ultimately fuel your strategy and help you reach your goal of generating more applications and job orders. The last thing that I want you to do is leave this presentation and try to implement all of them. All that's going to happen is you'll get frustrated when you run out of time or when things don't go perfect. So instead, start with one. Track the data on that initiative and then expand from there. For the next probably 20 or so minutes, we're going to look at tactics on social media that can help you generate more applications. The first, generating job board visits from Twitter specifically. Twitter is and always will be about the conversation. Looking for other job seekers that are asking questions, that are looking for work in your specific area. Driving job board visits from Twitter is a great way to get people back to your specific job board and through your conversion funnel. When you're sharing on Twitter, I encourage you to be extremely visual. Use a branded now hiring image if you have the creative capabilities to do so, if you have the software in-house to do so. If not, look at free sourced images or look at different platforms like Canva online where you can generate these images completely online. But what I encourage you to do is create thumb-stopping visuals. So as people are scrolling through Twitter, they not only see your post, but they see your imagery, they see your branding, and they see your logo. Even if they don't click on this post right now and they go directly back to your page, they still see your company, they see your organization, and it's another opportunity to get in front of potential job seekers, potential candidates that can then reach out to you at some point for an available opportunity. While this slide is specifically about using the company Twitter account, I would also encourage you to get your team's buy-in and share those jobs through their personal Twitter accounts. As you're mixing in jobs, you're mixing in content, other ideas that we'll talk about later on in this presentation, you'll create a healthy mix of content that will ultimately position you in a better light than the competition. And that's ultimately what we're seeking here. We're trying to create thumb-stopping content that will get people off of Twitter as quickly as possible and back to your job board where they can apply for an available opportunity. Somebody had a question that says, do you think posting job offers on social media is a good strategy for a staffing agency? I apologize. I saw the question after I started talking about it, but I absolutely think that you should share your jobs on social media. On Twitter, you can get into a frequency where you're posting multiple jobs a day, scatter that throughout the day. I read a study online that said the average life of a tweet is about 6 minutes. After 6 minutes, the likelihood of seeing that tweet diminishes drastically. If you're sharing on Facebook or LinkedIn, maybe only share one job a day, a hot job of the day. Maybe even scale that down where you're sharing a job every other day and you're supplementing in other content, other imagery, other blog articles or resources. But yeah, I absolutely recommend sharing your job posts on social media. While we talked about Twitter, we're going to pivot to Facebook. Job board visits from Facebook. There's three items on the page here that I want to discuss. One, leveraging Facebook Jobs, Facebook's new platform where you can post a job directly on Facebook and gather applications that way. Leveraging Facebook groups, and then leveraging remarketing tactics. So first, we'll talk about Facebook jobs. A few months ago, Facebook rolled out their own. I consider it a job board, but essentially, if you go to facebook.com/jobs, you'll see all of the jobs in your local area. Facebook knows where you're looking at the site from, so they're able to serve jobs for you specifically based on your area. What will then happen is as somebody sees that job in their newsfeed, if they click apply now, Facebook will scrape their profile, taking any of the information that they have available, whether it's their name, their past schooling, anything that they've made public on Facebook. And once they submit it, your staffing firm will get a Facebook message from that person, and you'll get a notification saying that they applied for your job. I consider this step one in the funnel. So if somebody goes through Facebook, they click apply now, it's very easy for them to apply for the job. I would reach out and say, hey, thank you for your interest in this available opportunity. This is step one of the process. For more information on this specific role and to complete the application, please visit, and then I would include a link back to the job on either your job board or wherever it's listed. I wouldn't run Facebook specifically as a job board yet. I don't think that the data capture that they have is enough to consider it a true application, but it's a fantastic lead, and it's a fantastic way to get your available positions in front of a Facebook user on Facebook's terms. The second option would be to leverage Facebook groups. So within your local area, look at different groups for now hiring. So if you go to Facebook and you search for now hiring, or you search by location, so for me it'd be Buffalo, New York, I would look for jobs in Buffalo. And then I search by groups, it'll show me any group that is related to that search. And what you'll find is there are applicants using these groups to find their next opportunity, whether it's different companies sharing that they have jobs available or it's applicants saying that they're looking for a new job. Leverage the community of the group and become a member of the community. Don't just go in and drop a job and leave, but instead scroll through the comments, see what value you can bring, and share that with people that are looking for opportunities, that are looking for information. I talked about sharing jobs on Twitter. On Facebook, you can do it very similar too. If you have opportunities on a specific job board or whether it's on your site, share that job on Facebook in a similar way to Twitter, linking back so that people can apply to it online. The last option here is what we at Haley Marketing Group consider re-recruiting. In the PPC world, it's considered remarketing. I have a whole slide dedicated to re-recruiting in the upcoming presentation. So for now, I'm going to hold off on that, but it's another incredible way to drive repeat visitors back to your job board. Another fantastic tactic to generate more applications would be to improve and increase form submissions on your website. So if you look at a piece of blog content on your website, or you just look at your website in general, are the sidebars working for you? And when I say are they working for you, is there a very calculated route that you want a job seeker to take when they land on a blog article or when they land on your website? And the example on the screen here, we've designed the sidebar to drive people either to skip the search and submit their resume or to browse over 100 available jobs. If you look at the fly-in, it says browse over 150 available jobs. The last option then is to contact this company directly. I believe this is the perfect way to design a sidebar. And the main reason, leave the comments and the questions for the end. So ideally, when somebody lands on your site, you want them to be able to take action without you. If they land on a piece of blog content or they land on the website in general and your sidebar is built with this structure, an applicant can submit their resume, they can apply for a job without ever having to pick up a phone or contact you. They can do it on their time, on their terms. Maybe it's 9:30 at night or 10 o'clock at night, they're on the couch, they don't have to call you with questions or comments. The site is built to funnel them to take action without your team. The next morning, you can go in and look at what happened, or the next week if you want to move at that frequency. But ideally, building out a sidebar and using your website as a conversion funnel is critical for success. Driving people back to your site, back to the job board, back to blog articles is just the first step in the process. Once they're there, we want to tell them their next step. The next step in this instance would be to submit a resume or apply for a job. So we had a question about reducing the amount of junk applications on Facebook. The application is so basic that anyone and everyone seems to apply for a job. That's a fantastic question and something that we see quite frequently. Because the application process is so convenient and easy, it's difficult to cut through that clutter. And really why I consider that step one in the process. What I would recommend is setting up Facebook's autoresponder. So if you go into your Messenger settings, when somebody contacts your page, you can set up an autoresponder that will essentially respond how you want it to. So as a job comes in, as an application comes in, and somebody leaves that message, your autoresponder can say, hey, first name, so hi, Brad. Thanks for reaching out to us on Facebook. If you're interested in one of our available jobs, please visit and then drive them to your job board. Get them off Facebook. If somebody takes that step, they're dedicated and committed to the next step in the process, they're more likely to convert through the funnel. Somebody that's just scrolling through Facebook and taps the button, it's really just a two-click process. So you're exactly right that it's easy for them to complete the application on Facebook, which is why I really consider it a lead and not a true application. It's a great question. Tactic three, blogging for placements. If you're not invested into the power of content marketing, I would begin as soon as possible and also research the benefits of content marketing. When you're sharing on social media, you need to have a healthy mix of content that isn't just job after job after job. Instead, you want to incorporate content that addresses the pain points of applicants so that as they're scrolling through their newsfeed, again, we have this thumb-stopping imagery, so people see it, they click on it, and it catches their attention. But ultimately, we want to drive them back to a blog article. We want to address their issues and pain points. The blog will not only build trust, it will not only show them that you are qualified to help them in their job search, but from there, going on the slide beforehand, we can then funnel them to the next step in the process. So just because we didn't share a job on Thursday, we shared a blog article instead, all the people that click on that blog article and read it are now also prompted to leave an application or apply for a job. Content marketing is a phenomenal way to get people back to your site, back to your homeland, and get them off of social media as quickly as possible. Something that I say quite frequently here at Haley Marketing Group is the number one goal is to get somebody off of social media as quickly as possible. And I oversee a vast majority of our social media accounts here, but ultimately I don't want that viewer to live on social. I want them back on our website because from there I've cut out any other noise from our competition. I've cut out other noise from family and friends and maybe it's ex-colleagues or people that they went to school with. I now have their attention on my homeland. On my website. So blogging is a great way to address the pain points of job seekers and candidates, also driving them back to your site. There's an interesting comment about whether or not you should share third-party content. Should you link people to Inc. or Forbes or Entrepreneur? I think that as a supplement, yes, you should sprinkle in great content when you come across it. If you see an article on Inc. and you enjoy it and you think it's great for your audience, you should absolutely share that. But it shouldn't be the end-all solution. Inc., Entrepreneur, Forbes, they get their own traffic, and they get more than enough of it. They don't need ours. We should be creating blog content that speaks, again, to the pain points of job seekers, of hiring managers, that drives people back to your website so that you can convert them through your sidebars and through your website's funnel. Emails and phone calls. Within blog content, you want to include a strong call to action. You want people to know what their next step should be. So whether it's through the sidebar or it's through copy at the bottom of the post, we want to tell the reader what their next step should be. By nature, they're going to want to read the article and then go back to Facebook, go back to Twitter. That's what they were doing beforehand. They want to return to that activity. We can prevent that from happening by creating some sort of intrusion that now tells them their next step. Instead of going back to Twitter, you should look at this article. You should read this post. If you're interested in seeing where your resume will take you, you should contact Nancy. Think about what that person would have thought about while reading your article, the questions that they might have, and then guide them to the next path. On Facebook, if you want to generate more phone calls, you can pivot the button at the top of your page to either say call now, which would link directly back to a phone number so that a user on mobile can reach out directly, or you can set that up to sign up for a newsletter. You can set it up to drive people back to a contact us page on your website. For this specific example, I set this one to say call now because I wanted to showcase what that functionality would do, but you can change that blue button to fit your specific needs. Generating more applications by first generating more website traffic from social media. If you don't have Google Analytics installed on your website, I would encourage you to contact your web developer before the month's over and get that installed. Google Analytics is a free dashboard that allows you to see how many people are looking at specific pages on your website and from what source they're coming from. So in this example, we looked at January to August data and compared 2017 to 2016. What we wanted to see was Social Pro traffic. So that's our fully managed social media marketing solution. It's a project and a program that I actually oversee here, but we wanted to look at traffic from social media to report back to this client whether or not the tactics that we were deploying were working. What we saw was that 239% more traffic came during 2017 than 2016. So because of the calculated tactics that we deployed, we were able to drive more people back to the website who then took action, who then applied for an opportunity, who then contacted this client. The main point for this slide is if you don't know how your website is performing, get Google Analytics installed on the site so that you can start to begin to interpret that data and understand what is working and what is not. By knowing what's not working, it's a great time to pivot your ideas, go back to the drawing board, and rethink what you're doing. At the beginning of the presentation, I said that step one of the roadmap to social media success is most critical, identifying our goals. If our goal is to get more people back to a contact us page, and in looking in Google Analytics, I see that I have less traffic back to that page from social media in this year, I'm not hitting my end goal. My social media strategy and my social media presence might look awesome. It might make me feel good because the imagery is pretty and it looks good. But ultimately, if it's not coming back to my end goal, we're wasting our time. And Google Analytics is a perfect way to identify what is and is not working. My next tactic, becoming an employer of choice through social media. Specifically, I want to talk about online reviews. If you haven't looked at your online presence and your online reviews, now's a great time to start paying attention to those. One of Facebook's ranking factors when it shows a staffing firm in search are the reviews that are left on that page. So if your competitor has 15 five-star reviews and you have 15 one-star reviews, and somebody goes into Facebook and they look for staffing firms in Buffalo, your competitor is going to show up. That's one of the ranking factors. There's a lot more to that equation, to that algorithm, but it is one of many ranking factors. So building online reviews. I'm going to go in depth a little bit more into building reviews on a later slide, but it's critical that we look and we consider how our page and how our reviews are performing on Facebook. If you want to become an employer of choice, I would also encourage you to pay attention to the number of likes on your page. as I talk to clients day after day, the number of likes on pages are usually a primary goal of a staffing firm that will come to us for support. My immediate rebuttal to that is that's not a goal, that's a tactic. The goal is I want more applications. The strategy is I'm going to become an employer of choice, and the tactic is we're going to get more Facebook likes in Q1, and we're going to increase by X percent in Q1. That is a tactic that I believe will get us to fuel our strategy and ultimately help us reach our goal. Again, circling back to Jay Bear, the goal is not to be good at social media. The goal is not to get 5,000 likes. The goal is to be good at business because of social media. The goal in this specific example is to get more job applications because of the tactic that we're deploying, which is a like campaign on Facebook. Attracting new candidates on social media. In the examples on your screen, you'll see that I looked at LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook. To attract new candidates on LinkedIn, I would start by searching for your specific area, your specific city. So in the example above, you'll see Buffalo. By then clicking on people and filtering by secondary connections, you'll be able to see people that you're connected to through somebody else. So if I'm connected to somebody through a coworker of mine, they would be a secondary connection. I recommend going through this and connecting with 25 to 35 people every single day. Grow your personal brand so that it becomes an asset when you're trying to recruit candidates. If you want to take this a step further, let's say again you're looking for welders, or you're looking for office support staff, or you're looking for sales representatives. If you're looking for sales representatives, I would do sales representative Buffalo, search by people, and then do secondary connections, and you'll see everybody on LinkedIn that is a sales representative in Buffalo that you can now connect with. They might not be looking for a job right now, but eventually they may be. What we're hoping to do is that they remember you, they start to see the content and the jobs that you're sharing on LinkedIn. And when they make the decision to look for a new job, they reach out to you before they reach out to your competition. On Twitter, you can search by city as well, and you'll see all of the companies or smaller pages. In this example, it's all Little Loop or youth sports pages. I would go through and look at who is following that page and then follow those people. Maybe it's 15 people a day, 20 people a day. But if somebody from Cherry Creek is following Cherry Creek football, and it's a youth football league, we can make the decision and the determination that they're from Cherry Creek. There's really no other reason for that individual to be following that youth organization on Twitter. If you're a staffing firm that staffs in Cherry Creek, that's a great way to build your talent pool in your local market on Twitter. The last idea is one that I touched on in the slide before, but attracting new candidates through a like campaign on Facebook. Take your ATS list, export that, and through Facebook advertising, upload that list and serve ads to people on Facebook to like your page. But we're doing it strategically. We're not just getting likes. We're not just getting likes from people in Buffalo. If you staff in San Diego or you staff in Seattle, it doesn't matter if somebody from Buffalo liked your page. Ultimately, we want to have targeted likes on the page. So by taking an email list, we can be certain that the people that have once applied for a job or are now in our database are now liking the page. Activating passive candidates. In a prior slide, I consider this re-recruiting. That's what Haley Marketing Group has coined it. This is a tactic that you can deploy on your own. It would be considered remarketing, but we have coined it as re-recruiting. If you've been on Amazon in the past 6 months and looked at a product, chances are that as you left Amazon and went to Facebook, that product followed you. That's considered remarketing. Amazon has remarketing code on their website, so when you look at a product and you don't purchase it, and you go to Facebook, you see the product still. increasing the likelihood that you go back to Amazon and actually purchase that item. In staffing, what we've considered re-recruiting, we've deployed this tactic where as somebody comes, an applicant comes to a job board on one of our clients' websites, and they look at an available job, as they go out to Facebook, they see ads for the specific staffing company, driving them back to apply now. We found that repeat visitors to a staffing website are twice as likely to apply for a job than new visitors, and this data allowed us the opportunity to understand that this was essential. So if we're driving people back to our job board through the other tactics that I've outlined in the presentation already, we can put remarketing code on their machine, whether it's their phone or their computer, but we can put remarketing code so that as they go to Facebook, now we're bringing them back in. We're creating this loop and this circle where we're not just driving new people, but we're getting them in one time, and then we're looping them back into the funnel. They might not be looking for a job opportunity now. They might be a passive candidate, but eventually when they need a new opportunity or they need a new job, you're top of mind. They're going to contact you first. What we found with the imagery, we have a lot of fun with it. So instead of saying hire or now hiring or apply today, we have imagery where it says you deserve better. We get it. Your job sucks. The one behind it is mo money, mo problems. So we have this thumb-stopping content, this thumb-stopping imagery where it's not simply now hiring, looking for a job, looking for work. It's more eye-catching because we want people to take that action and come back to the site. I'm going to touch real quickly on reactivating past candidates through email marketing. I understand that this is a social media presentation, but social media and email marketing intersect. And for me to talk about the roadmap to social media success without considering email marketing would be an oversight on my part. If you have past candidates, I would encourage you at least on a monthly basis to email them your 4 to 5 top opportunities on a monthly basis. Somebody that you put on assignment a year ago that might not be coming back or calling you on a daily basis. They might not be reaching out frequently. By still emailing them and telling them, hey, we have these 4 opportunities available, you're keeping your brand top of mind. They can take action if they want to. They can learn more or apply now. They can also forward this to a friend. So I might not be looking for a job right now, but if you helped, you've helped me in the past and now you're staying top of mind, you're sending me your top jobs on a monthly basis, and now my friend Brian's looking for a job, I can forward this to him in one click of a button. So you're making that viral nature, you're making it easy, accessible, but you're also staying top of mind. The last tactic that I want to discuss in leveraging social media to drive more applications is to showcase your brand identity. Be human on social media. If you're not sharing things from the office, your team, different success stories, there's an example right in the screen, I got my job at temp staff. Be proud of who you are and be proud of the people that you put to work on a daily basis. What's awesome about this temp staff example is not only will this individual see the post and feel great about it, but his family's going to see this post and they're going to share it. His friends are going to share this post. And when they do so, now your company is getting in front of people that you might not be familiar with. They might not be familiar with you. But because of the nature of the individual in the post, we're using that as a catalyst to drive other people back to your page to get to know who you are. Showcase your brand identity. It's a great spot to leverage Instagram for. If you look at the Haley Marketing Instagram account, it's managed by Michelle Sears on our team. She goes through it on a weekly basis, is sharing content from around our office. It's not promotional. We don't talk about the services that we offer. We don't talk about really the products that we put out, but we showcase the team. So if you look at our Instagram account, what I would recommend you to do, as you look at that account, you become more comfortable with us, so that if you do decide to work with us or partner with us, you already know who we are and you understand who we are as individuals, not just as a company. To be mindful of time, if you do have questions about generating applications, please use the chat window. I'm going to talk and just continue directly into social media tactics to generate more job orders but I do want to address any questions that may come through. So if there's any tactic that I outlined or that I discussed, something that maybe you tried and it just didn't work at all, I would love to hear that feedback in the chat window. Social tactics to generate more job orders. Again, we're going to look at contact form submissions. If we're blogging consistently and we're driving people back to our website and our blog through content, the reader should know their next step when they get to it. So for this example, if you look at the blog, this blog pivots to address the next step for a hiring manager, whether it's request an employee or to sign up for a newsletter that would give them more information about managerial topics. Because of the topic of the blog, the sidebar changes accordingly. So if it was a piece of job seeker content, we would want it to say apply now, but if it's HR content, we want it to say request an employee. And again, as they get to the bottom of that blog article, we want a nice, bold call to action banner button where we can tell people what their next step should be as they get to it. One-to-one contact with hiring managers. Again, for me to not talk about email marketing while we're outlining the roadmap to social media success would be a disservice to you. If you're just emailing candidates, I would look into deploying a separate newsletter campaign that targets your clients, that targets hiring managers, whether it's prospects, whether it's people that you work with on a monthly basis that are still putting through job orders. Stay top of mind with them. You might not reach out to every single client on a monthly basis, so this email campaign that you automate or you put together on a monthly basis is a phenomenal way to stay in front of the people that you're not talking to. Another thing that you can do is use LinkedIn's Pulse functionality where you go in and you publish a blog article directly on LinkedIn. If you're running blog content on your site, I would encourage you to wait a week and then share that on LinkedIn as a full article. Include links throughout the article that link back to your website, that link back to specific actionable pages, so that as somebody reads it, they know the next step and they know to go to your page for additional information. Blogging for job orders. I touched on this when we talked about our call to action and our sidebars. If you're blogging, make sure you're also addressing the pain points of hiring managers, of clients, so that when they have a need, they know that you're qualified to address that pain point. Create great blog articles that take people from social media and get them off of there as quickly as possible. The mindless scrolling on social media is one of our biggest challenges. We need to create some stopping content that will get people to get off of social and give us their undivided attention. So using imagery that's branded with a nice, strong link back to some content, but ultimately we have to address the pain points of that client. We don't want blog content that's self-serving. We want to address the questions or concerns that they might be having. Becoming a trusted resource through reviews. You can use reviews, and I would also encourage you to verify your Facebook page to become a trusted resource. If you go into the settings of your Facebook page, you can request to verify that page. What will happen is Facebook will call your office directly. They'll give you an access code or a verification code, rather. You'll type that in, and then your page will be verified. They just want to confirm that the number you have listed is really who you say you are. Verifying your page along with reviews are another way to increase the likelihood that when somebody searches a generic phrase like staffing firms in Buffalo on Facebook, you show up ahead of your competition. To become a trusted resource, I would also encourage you to actively grow and generate positive feedback, grow testimonials. And the easiest way to do that is to simply ask. If you know you have a client who loves working with you, ask them for quick feedback. Ask them to leave you a testimonial. Ask them to go to Facebook and leave a quick review. If your Glassdoor rating is really low, go to Glassdoor and leave that review. But wherever you pick, make sure that you're driving people back and simply asking. Strive for 5 stars. This is great for clients. It's also great for candidates. If you put somebody on location or you put somebody on an assignment and you know that they absolutely love it, ask them to leave you that feedback. Reactivating past clients through skill marketing. So we talk about showcasing jobs on your website, but why not showcase the individuals that you can put to work once that job order comes through? So if you look at the examples on the page, through skill marketing, we're leveraging the expertise of the individual so that as a hiring manager, as a potential client or a prospect comes to the site, they see that you have the individuals that are ready for work tomorrow, that are ready for work next week. Using skill marketing, we can then push that out to social media. The company, the Armada Group, does a great job at saying, check out our rock star talent. You click on that link, it goes back to this page where you can see all the individuals that work with them, that put their trust in them to find them a career opportunity. But it's great because the call to action is then to request an employee. So if they're looking to request an employee, driving them back to this landing page, back to the talent showcase, as we call it, but a showcase where you're showing your top talent and leveraging that is a phenomenal way to get hiring managers and prospects back to your website through your conversion funnel. So now what? We've talked about over 25 different tactics that you can deploy. We identified our strategies. We looked at our two main goals of every staffing and recruiting firm. Now what? It's critical that we check the data and we identify if we reached our goals. Going back to Jay Baird, the goal is not to be good at social media. The goal is to be good at business because of social media. In step one of the roadmap to social media success, we outline SMART goals. Are they specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound? We outlined how we can make a wish and a hope a SMART goal. We set our goal. We set a timestamp on it. We deployed a strategy and we deployed tactics. Well, now it's time to look at the data. Did we reach our goals? If we set out to generate 50 welding applications from Buffalo, New York by February 20th, and it's February 21st, did we hit that goal? We can then identify our wins and losses and launch another initiative. So we can go back to the drawing board and go all the way back to square one. What is our goal for Q2? What are we trying to accomplish? Okay, we know we want to generate more applications. What strategy should we deploy to help us get there? Okay, we're going to go with becoming an employer of choice. From there, what tactics can we deploy? We are going to launch a like campaign. We are going to increase our positive reviews on Facebook. And we are going to share great content 3 times a day so that people know that we are the preferred staffing firm in our local market. Identify your wins and losses, and then launch another initiative. If it's successful, great, stick to it. If it's not, back to the drawing board. Let's figure out what we can pivot, what can we change so that in Q2 we are successful. Not hitting your goals isn't necessarily a bad thing. It just means that you need to rethink your process and rethink the tactics that you deployed to ultimately help you reach your goals. Again, my name is Brad Biley. I want to thank everybody for joining me this afternoon. Amanda and Tricom, I want to thank you for having me on this webinar series. If you have questions, I will stay on the line for a while and answer those for you, whether they're in the chat window or the questions window. But if you have questions after the presentation as well, my email address is on the screen. I'd be happy to chat with anybody, whether it's about your specific social media strategies and tactics that your company is deploying, or something that you're doing on a personal level. Maybe it's trying to grow that personal brand and you need a little bit of guidance. I'd be happy to chat with you about that. But I will stay on the line and answer any questions that come through the window. And again, thank you very much for having me on this webinar series. And thank you for going on the journey and the roadmap to social media success.
Brad, thank you very much. Okay, so go ahead and submit any questions that you have at this time. And we'll be also opening a poll so you can give us some feedback on today's session and any ideas that you may have for future sessions of other topics that you may be interested in learning more about. So I do have a couple of questions that have come in. One of them is asking about that Facebook job solutions. And is that a good solution for generating more applications? Or what is a preferred social media site for job applications?
Generating applications through social is really going to depend on your specific industry. So if you're in the light industrial staffing industry and you do that light industrial or warehouse type of staffing, I would put heavy focus on Facebook, whether it's Facebook jobs, whether it's posting Facebook job, just the actual job itself and driving people back to your website to apply or back to your job board. But for that space, Facebook works really well. I've also seen it work really well in healthcare, nursing. If you're looking for senior executives or you're looking for sales team members or you're looking for a hard-to-fill position, IT, tech, you're going to want to invest more time into LinkedIn. We've seen LinkedIn work really well for those specific industries. Facebook jobs as a tactic, as I mentioned in the throughout the presentation, it's a great way to generate leads, but I wouldn't let that be the end-all solution. So if Brad Biley were to apply for a job through Facebook jobs and you saw that, I wouldn't count that as a full application. I would count that as step one in the process. Drive that individual back to the job board, back to the specific job, where they can take the next steps and fill out the full application, submit a resume, give you all their information, and go from there.
Okay. And you mentioned LinkedIn. Is there a different type of approach that you would use in posting jobs on LinkedIn versus how you would post jobs in Facebook, for example?
Sharing a great visual on LinkedIn is a great way to cut through that noise. I would also put focus on video content on LinkedIn, and video is something that I didn't really touch on too much throughout the presentation, but pulling up your iPhone or your smartphone and filming a video about a job that you're trying to fill, talking about the ideal candidate, the skills that they might have, the qualities that they might have, exactly who you're looking for. Sharing that on LinkedIn is a great way to cut through the noise. As I scroll through my personal LinkedIn, and I'm connected now with over 8,000 individuals, I still don't see a lot of that video content. So it's a great way to be a first mover and really use a tool that's new to the platform that not a lot of people are taking advantage of.
And that is great information for the candidate side. And as you know, for staffing companies, the other side of that would be clients and getting new clients or getting in front of hiring managers. Do you know of a good social platform to reach a business?
For businesses, I would focus on, again, LinkedIn. If you're looking at search and going through, look at hiring managers in Buffalo. Search by the actual decision maker that you would have to talk to. Look for searching through LinkedIn and going by secondary connections, as I touched on, but looking for the actual individual that you would have to talk to at a given company. If you're looking at getting into a specific company and you want to staff for a specific company and you know they're a large, let's say a large prospect in your area, search by that company on LinkedIn, go by people, and start connecting with individuals that work at that company. You can get your name in front of those individuals. You can get the organization in front of those individuals. And then as you share content, as you share related jobs, they'll see that you can help them. You can be the solution that they're looking for.
Great suggestions. Is it okay to share my team and brand personality in social media?
I actually highly encourage it. So getting to know who you are is a great differentiator from your competition. At Haley Marketing, we invest all of our Instagram content into who we are and growing the personal brand. So if we can address who we are as individuals, then when a new client comes in or even a new prospect, they know who we are before that project gets assigned to us. I would encourage you to do the same. So if you have, let's say, a receptionist at your office, post a Q&A video where you go through the 5 to 10 things that they love to see when somebody walks through for a first interview, or common questions from first interviews that they might get as a new applicant comes through the door. Not only will that help somebody as they're coming through, but they become more comfortable with your receptionist. So now when they come in for that interview, they're not nervous. They're comfortable. You're going to get a true representation of who they are so that you can move forward with that interview process.
You mentioned thumb-stopping imagery. Can you give us an idea of what that might be or something that we should be looking for to try and create that?
That is a phenomenal question. So thumb-stopping imagery is really the challenge that everybody is after right now. When you look at social media, and as a staffing firm, posts on social media that you post are competing with your competitors, they're competing with friends, family, they're competing with other sports teams, news organizations, local bands, world-famous bands, local news. There's a lot of noise. So when I talk about thumb-stopping imagery, I would mention imagery, and I would share imagery that speaks to emotion, imagery that will catch somebody's attention, that will get them to take the next step. I wish that I had the secret recipe, because we would be a lot more effective on social media if I had that key. But it's going to vary, and you'll find that you can share one post on Friday and it might get a lot of clicks back to your website, share the same image on a different day and it might not resonate as well. It's all about identifying what's working, looking at the data, and then using that to make a decision moving forward. There's an interesting point there too then of what times are working well for you. I'm a big proponent of sharing content after hours and before hours. So you work, let's say, 8 to 5 Monday through Friday. It's easy for you because you're at your computer to share resources on Facebook during that time. However, the people that you're trying to reach are also at work, and they shouldn't be on their phone. They shouldn't be on their computer, unless that's their job, looking at Facebook. So they don't necessarily have the same time frame as you. I like sharing content in the morning before people get to work, and I like sharing content late at night. You think about parents that might have children, share content after 9:30, maybe it's after 10, after the kids are asleep and all the other tasks that they have for the day are done. Now it's time to unwind and scroll through Facebook.
Great point. The last question that's come in here is, how do I actively build online reviews?
Building online reviews, the number one way that you can do that is to simply ask. If you have a employee on location, you have someone that came through and you place them and they love their assignment, I would ask them to leave a review. And next time you see them, or maybe it's a quick email, give them the link and ask them to leave a review. You can provide an incentive if you want. So maybe it's a $5 card to Starbucks or another local coffee shop. And provide some sort of incentive in exchange for that review. But the number one thing that you can do is ask people, employees on assignment or clients that you know have a great relationship with you, ask them for that feedback, just like you did at the end of this presentation. You know, with everybody on the call and listening in, natively, you might not want to leave that feedback, but because you're prompted to do so, you know that there's a next step to this. You know that now we're asking for that feedback. People will certainly give that feedback as long as they're prompted to do so.
Okay, I have one other question here. How do you navigate the line between presenting a professional voice on social media while being fun and conversational?
So it's a great question. You need to first identify how your brand wants to talk on social. So for us specifically, we are a fun organization. We get together quite frequently outside of the office. We genuinely care about each other. So for us to share content about our individuals and our team is second nature to us because that's who we are at Haley Marketing Group. We have a volleyball team that goes out twice a week and plays. We have all these other team builders and events. So for us to share our brand personality makes a lot of sense. We are still professional in the sense of when somebody asks us a question, we respond to it. If somebody has negative feedback, we address it professionally. We're not going to criticize somebody or attack somebody. We always want to put our best foot forward on social. But identifying how your brand wants to look and act and feel on social is another one of the tactics, really. Really thinking about how you want to portray yourself.
Great questions. Again, I've gone ahead and put the contact information up on the slide. If you have any further questions or like additional information as it relates to social media, please feel free to contact Brad directly. If you have any other questions, you can also reach out to me. We will have a recording of this webinar available on our website. And if you'd like a handout of today's PowerPoint, you can reach out to Brad directly, and he'd be happy to share that information with you and help you in your social media goals. As we're running out of time here, we'll go ahead and wrap things up. But again, thank you all for your participation in today's webinar session. And Brad, thank you for sharing all of that information on the roadmap and a step-by-step guide to building social media success. I hope to see you on our next webinar sessions, and thank you again. Have a wonderful afternoon.